సైన్స్ ఆఫ్ ప్లాంట్స్. సో జనరల్ ఏంటంటే సైన్స్ ఆఫ్ ప్లాంట్స్ సో వి డీల్స్ అబౌట్ దట్ బయాలజీ ఫస్ట్ వి ఓకే సో డీల్ అబౌట్ దట్ బయాలజీ. బయాలజీ మీన్స్ ఇట్ ఈస్ అ స్టడీ ఆఫ్ లివింగ్ ఆర్గానిజమ్స్. ఆర్ స్టడీ ఆఫ్ లైఫ్ దట్ ఈస్ నోన్ యాజ్ అ బయాలజీ. సో బయాలజీ ఈజ్ డెరివ్డ్ ఫ్రమ్ గ్రీక్ లాంగ్వేజ్. గ్రీక్ లాంగ్వేజ్ సో ఇట్ ఈస్ డెరివ్డ్ ఫ్రమ్ టూ గ్రీక్ వర్డ్స్. బయోస్ మీన్స్ లైఫ్, లాగోస్ మీన్స్ స్టడీ. లాగోస్ మీన్స్ స్టడీ ఆర్ డిస్కస్. ఓకే సో దట్ ఈస్ నోన్ యాజ్ ద బయాలజీ. ఆఫ్టర్ దట్ సో బయాలజీ ఈజ్ వెల్ డెవలప్ అట్ ద 20th సెంచరీ. బయాలజీ ఈజ్ వెల్ డెవలప్ అట్ ద 20th సెంచరీ బై ద అప్లికేషన్ ఆఫ్ బయోఫిజిక్స్ అండ్ బయోకెమికల్ మెథడ్స్ ఆర్ అప్లైడ్. బయోఫిజిక్స్ అండ్ బయోకెమికల్ మెథడ్స్ ఆర్ అప్లైడ్ సో ఇన్ దట్ అట్ ద టైమ్ ఆఫ్ 20th సెంచరీ. సో వాట్ ఆర్ దట్ క్రోమటోగ్రఫీ, సెంట్రిఫికేషన్, అండ్ స్పెక్ట్రోస్కోపీ, అండ్ ఎక్స్రే క్రిస్టలోగ్రఫీ. క్రిస్టలోగ్రఫీ ఓకే ఇట్ మీన్స్ బై ద యూజింగ్ ఆఫ్ క్రోమటోగ్రఫీ, సెంట్రిఫికేషన్ అండ్ స్పెక్ట్రోస్కోపీ అండ్ క్రిస్టలోగ్రఫీ. సో ఇట్ ద 20th సెంచరీ సో ఇట్ ఈస్ వెల్ డెవలప్ ఎట్ ద 20th సెంచరీ బయాలజీ ఈజ్ వెల్ డెవలప్ that's why it is known as golden era of biology. In molecular diagnostics also it means biotechnology is well developed with the 20th century. That's why it is known as that golden era of biology. It is the objective bit. Okay, so after that so it means origin of botany and development of that botany. After that, origin of botany. Generally, botany is derived from Greek language. Derived from Greek language. Okay, in this means, bos means cattle. Boskin means cattle feed. Boskin means cattle feed. After then, boskin is converted into that botane. Then botane is changed to that botany. Okay, that is the origin of botany. So botany is derived from Greek language. Bos means cattle, boskin means cattle feed. So when the time is going on, so in that boskin is converted into botany. Botany is now is considered as that botany. Okay, so that is known as that origin of botany, right? After that, development of that botany. Development. So before the Christ, so it means, so plants are divided into different groups based on that. Okay, so it means natural sources like that food, shelter, and clothes, then and medicinal purpose. So plants are used cultivation before. Okay, Christ, plants are also growing. So plants are also cultivated. So at the development, how it is that? For example, at the time of 4000 BC, Egyptians and Assyrians Egyptians and Assyrians recorded information about crop plants plus and fruit trees in the form of pictures. These pictures are known now, they are called, the pictures are also known as hieroglyphics. Means pictures of fruit trees and crop plants by the Egyptians and Assyrians in 4000 BC. So after that, in 2500 BC, Chinese are learned. Chinese are learned how to cultivated crop plants. How to cultivate crop plants. So after that, in 2000 BC, in Atharvana Veda, medicinal plants are studied. Medicinal plants are studied. Right? Medicinal plants are studied. So in 2000 BC. Okay? So that is known as that. In Atharvana Veda, 2000 BC, medicinal plants are studied. So after that, in the year of 1300 BC, Parashara wrote two famous books. In 1300 BC, Parashara, he wrote two famous books. First one is that Vrikshayurveda. First one is the Krishi Parasharam. Second one is the Vrikshayurveda. Was a famous Indian botanist. Okay, Parashara wrote two famous books. First one is the Krishi Parasharam, second one is the Vrikshayurveda. In Krishi Parasharam, he explained that different kinds of crop plants, and weed plants are studied. Crop plants and weed plants are studied in Krishi Parasharam. After that, Vrikshayurveda, it explained that different kinds of forests, mostly 14 types of forests, external and internal characters are studied. External and internal characters are studied. Okay, so and medicinal plants also studied. In this include that medicinal plants. Okay, so that is known as that 1300 BC Parashara wrote two famous books. After the Parashara, Socrates, Plato and Aristotle helped for the development of botany into science. After that, famous Greek philosophers helped for the development of botany into science. What are that? Plato, Socrates, and Aristotle. So Plato, Socrates and Aristotle, they are the famous Greek philosophers, helped development of botany into science. Development of botany into science. Right? After that, Plato and Aristotle student Theophrastus in 340 BC, at the time of 340 BC, so especially he studied about the plants. He explained that 500 kinds of 500 kinds of external and internal characters. External and internal characters in his book. This book name was De Historia Plantarum. De Historia Plantarum. So he wrote famous book De Historia Plantarum. It is also known as inquiry into plants. Inquiry into plants. So he specially studied about the plants. So 500 kinds of external and internal characters of plants are studied. He wrote famous book, he explained in famous book De Historia Plantarum, or it is also known as the Inquiry into Plants. That's why Theophrastus are described as father of botany. He described as father of botany. So it is an objective book. Who is that father of botany? Theophrastus. What was his book name? Was De Historia Plantarum book. Okay, or inquiry into that plants. He was a student of Plato and Aristotle in 340 BC, specially studied. So about the plants, he explained that 500 kinds of external and internal characters of the plants. He wrote another famous book. So that is known as that Causae Plantarum. He wrote another book, so that is known as Causae Plantarum. It means it is known as that causes of plants. So in that causes of plants, he explained that so morphological, physiological, and anatomical characters. Okay, by that Theophrastus scientist. Okay, it is the second book, Causae Plantarum, causes of plants. After that, during the time of 17th century, experimental studies occur on surrounding living plants. So this period is known as that Renaissance period. Renaissance period. So it is known as that 17th century. So at that time, it means Greek, okay, scientists, they are identified medicinal plants, identified medicinal plants and written their books these books are known as herbals. Herbals means, so during the time of Renaissance period, scientists identified that medicinal plants and written in their books. So these books are herbals. They are known as herbalists. They are known as that herbalists during the time of 17th century. So after that, in the 17th and 18th century, so during the time Robert Hooke, identify the cell. And he wrote famous book, the book name was Micrographia. The book name was Micrographia. So Robert Hooke identified the cell for the first time. He wrote famous book Micrographia during the time of 17th century. Okay, so in this one, this cell is that non-living, non-living thing. Okay, so it is identified from that cork tissue or bark. Okay, so at that time, so in the, he take a thin piece of that bark from that oak tree. It is this thin, okay, so pieces of bark is observed, okay, with the help of the microscope. So in that microscope, so this thin bark producing of that, okay, compartment like structures. So this compartment like structures, these showing of that compartment like structures, okay, they are that okay, like honeybees, like honeybee, okay. So these compartment like structures are known as that rooms. It means in Latin language cella means room. Then nowadays they are converted into that cell. Okay, so Robert Hooke identified for the first time, okay, non-living, okay, so thing that is known as the cell from the bark. He wrote famous book that is known as that Micrographia. So this all are that important according to that objective. Okay, after that Gaspard Bauhin for the first time introducing of the binomial nomenclature at the time of 17th and 18th century. Gaspard Bauhin introducing binomial nomenclature for the first time. It means a name having with two components. A name having with two words. It is, okay, proposed by the first time Gaspard Bauhin. After that, it is developed by or popularized by Carolus von Linnaeus. Carolus von Linnaeus. So this Carolus von Linnaeus also explained that sexual system of classification. Carolus von Linnaeus in sexual system of classification. So he used that, okay, reproductive organs for classification of the plants. He used reproductive parts of plant. So what are the reproductive plants? Stamens, male reproductive organs, and carpels, they are that female reproductive organs. So they are used for that, okay, classification of the plants, reproductive parts of plants. First one is that male reproductive organ, that stamen. Second one is the carpel, That's why they are known as a sequel system of classification. Okay, so that is known as that Carolus 1 Linnaeus. After that, Nehemiah grew, Marf grew, and Marcello Malfigi scientists are helped for development of anatomy. Development of histology and anatomy. Anatomy. At that 18th century, Camerarius identified sexual reproduction in plants. Sexual reproduction in plants, okay? After that 19th century, at the time of 19th century, Gregor John Mendel experiments takes place or occur on pea plants. For the first time, for detailed explaining of inheritance of loss. Inheritance of loss. Okay, inheritance means parental characters are, okay, goes from, okay, so genetical characters are goes from parents to offsprings, that is known as the inheritance. Parental characters are, okay, inherited to that, it means offsprings or children. So this process is known as that inheritance of loss. They are known as the Mendelian principles. Okay, genetical experiments are takes place on pea plants. Genetical experiments occur on pea plants. So this pea plant is known as that garden pea. Scientific name is known as Pisum sativum. Belongs to Fabaceae family. That's why, so it is also known as that he was also considered as father of genetics. Okay, father of genetics in that 19th century. At the same that in the 19th century, Ernest Haeckel environmental factors, development of that ecology, ecological factors, for the development of ecological So Ernest Haeckel, that's why he was the father of ecology. He described as father of ecology. After that, Edward Buchner, scientist. Identify the gymase enzyme. From yeast cell. Okay, so this all process are occur at during the time of 19th century. After the 20th century, mostly it is involvement of that cell biology. Cell biology is well developed during the time of 20th century. During a time of 20th century, cell biology well developed. During the time of 20th century. So in this, what are that? First one is that chromosomes, chromosome theory. Chromosome theory is explained by that Sutton and Boveri. What is the meaning of chromosome theory? It means chromosomes are involved in inheritance process. Okay, during the time of cell division, chromosomes are mainly involved in so inheritance process. They are known as physical basis of heredity. Physical basis of heredity. It is that objective bit. It is explained by that Sutton and Boveri. So after that, mutation process. Mutations are for the first time identified by that Hugo de Vries, scientist, in Enothera, evening primrose. Enothera in evening primrose. In evening primrose. So after that, tissue culture is well developed by the White, Nitch, Maheshwari and Guha. Okay, so after that, introducing of that DNA double helix model, introduced by that Watson Crick, scientist. DNA double helix. Explained by Watson and Crick, scientist. Next, RNA structure is explained by Conrad, scientist. Okay, so that is known as that cell biology is well developed. After that, plant physiology is also well developed. It means J.B. Sumner crystallized that urease enzyme. Crystallize urease enzyme from the for the first time from the jog bean. Okay, so plant physiology is also well developed. After that, light reaction explained by that Arnon, hill, Blackman, and Emerson. Right? After that, C3 cycle explained by that Kelvin scientist, and he got Nobel Prize for explaining of the C3 cycle. And after that, C4 cycle, C4 cycle. So this C4 cycle is explained by that Hatch-Slack scientist. That is known as Hatch-Slack method. Okay. So in the C3 cycle, this primary, at the time of carbon fixation, the first primary product is the PGA. This PGA having that 3 carbon substance. Okay. So it takes place in the stroma part at the time of carbon fixation. So then what is that primary product? PGA, it having the 3 carbons. So that is the primary product, that's why it is known as a C3 cycle. In some plants, okay, at the time of carbon fixation, it does not having that 3 carbon substance, it is producing of that 4 carbon compound. This 4 carbon compound is known as the oxaloacetic acid. So that's why it is known as a C4 cycle. Okay, C4 cycle is, okay, having ability to grow in high temperature regions compared to that C3 plants. It is involved performing more photosynthesis than that C3 plants at a high temperature also, right? After that, FW went identify auxins. Okay, next one, gibberellins, cytokinins, all are identified that at the time of the 20th century. At the 20th century, plant physiology is well developed. After that, in that C4 cycle, identify in India by Professor V.S. Ramadas. He extensively work on that only that C4 plants. Belongs to that SV University. It is that it is a 2017 Eamcet bit. Eamcet bit. So which scientist? Okay, so studying in C4 plants in India by Professor V.S. Ramadas. Okay, so that is known as that plant physiology. Plant physiology. After that, plant physiology, after plant physiology, some scientists are helped for the development of palynology. So this palynology means, so it is deals about the study of pollen grains. So what are that? P.K. Nayar, C.G.K. Ramanujam. 1 minute. C.G.K. Ramanujam and Sunirmal. Okay, so they are helped for the development of that palynology. So after the, so many scientists are, so explain the different system of classification. They are known as that phylogenetic system of classification. So this phylogenetic system of classification, so what are that? It means Hutchinson, Takhtajan, Goldberg, Okay, so they are, okay, development to the phylogenetic system of classification. They are involved, so they are used, okay, evolutionary character for classification of the plants. So that is known as that development of botany.